What's up, y'all? We're Dillinger Escape Plan and shit.
And you is getting your fix.
Metal injection, dog.
That's right.
Hello, metal injection junkies. Rob here with Greg and Ben of the Dillinger Escape Plan. A few weeks away from the release of your new album, One of Us is the Killer.
Is that?
Are you excited to, like, for you guys? I'm sure it's like, it's done already. It's out of your... out of your hair, right? You're just worried about playing?
It's crazy. It's like if you baked a cake and nobody has, you gotta wait till 2 months for someone to eat it, for God's sakes.
Do you remember the date
we
of baked completion?
A cake and no one can try it.
When was this cake finished baking?
When did we bake this?
March 8th,
many layers
around
cake.
There? Was it when Master was turned in?
Yeah.
We started at November 15th. We were supposed to turn it... No, we started November 6th. We were supposed to turn it in December 16th, and we turned it in on March the 8th.
What was the delay?
Depends on who you ask, really.
I mean, whose fault? Just let's point some fingers.
No, we just take a long time, you know, sometimes to dictate. We're very perfectionistic, and like the older we get, the more, you know, kind of like not just hard on ourselves, but hard on our producer, you know, like we're like, do that again. We mixed one song for 2 weeks.
Just don't rush it, you know? It's like we never wanted to be this assembly line of music where like this is the allotted date to make a record. This is like, it's just whenever we're ready, we make it. And
you know, look at things on a long timeline where you're like, your band's going to be around for a while. We want to do this for a while. You only make records every 3 years or so. You're not going to care when you look back whether or not your record had to get pushed back by a month. You know, you're just going to care whether or not it's good. And if you thought of it, like he was saying, like an assembly line, like, okay, here's the touring cycle. Now we got to start writing. Now we got to put a record out. Now we got to do touring. That's ridiculous. You're not making pizzas and delivering them. You know what I mean?
Right.
Like you're trying to make something that 10 years from now you're going to listen back to and be proud of.
When do you know to step away from the music?
I'm usually working on the song until the second it is mastered and finished. Like even while it's being mastered, I'll be like, wait, I did this little noise here, send it in, or blah, 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 you know? So until it's like mastered, like the master is done.
So like when you come into the studio, do you go to work right away, or do you have to kind of like get in the zone by checking Facebook and Instagram?
We make coffee for like 4 hours.
Yeah. We have to get the best brew.
And then someone gets hungry, and then we're like, okay, we're going to get food. No, we actually really kind of do just work constantly.
Yeah.
But the sooner you start, you get there, that's when your energy's the freshest, you know?
Yeah.
You kill yourself the longer you sit around, you know? If I get there, I want to start singing 10 minutes after I walk in the door. I don't want to fart around and act like I need to watch TV or play the video game or something like that. That's not why I'm there. Yeah. I'm ready to go, you know?
Speaking of farting around, you fart around on tour. I got it.
Nobody wants to fart around.
But yeah, you know, I just want to get in and get shit done. And I mean, we do really long days. You know, we'll start at like noon and not wrap up until like 2 a.m. Okay. And we pretty much just work constantly except for like going to eat or, you know, yeah.
Do you listen to any other music while you're recording, or is it just the stuff you're working on?
Once I start working on stuff, I really don't listen to anything else.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I feel like, you know, you owe it to yourself to immerse yourself completely. You know, like, I don't want to hear outside influence. I definitely don't want to hear any other heavy bands. Like, and your ears are so tired. I mean, especially from, like, when you're doing vocals, like, you have enclosures on. I have the volume really loud.
He's screaming in his own ears, basically.
Yeah, I'm screaming in my own ears. The last thing I want, I mean, you get ear fatigue. So, like, when I'm... as soon as I'm done, like I just can't even imagine listening to music. You know, even on tour, I listen to so little music, like when we're off stage, because it's just always noise around. Like you really start to value having like complete silence. You know?
Oh, interesting. Yeah. So the two songs that I've heard so far sound pretty spastic, and I like in previous records you've kind of it's been a combination of that and then more like mellower, a little more industrial stuff. Is that kind of what we could expect with this new stuff?
Yeah, it's pretty diverse, this record.
Dubstep? A lot of wub wub wub.
There's a lot of wobble wobble. I mean, it's pretty much, I think, what somebody would expect from Dillinger, but then there's always going to be those moments that are like, wow, oh, okay, I've never heard this in Dillinger before.
There are things that we do that we're aware of, like patterns or like habits or like, and you know, we've kind of done, you know, become aware of those things.
Yeah, we consciously tried to put ourselves in different uncomfortable scenarios, you know, rhythmically and all these things that...
Right.
Just to make sure that we were challenging ourselves. And I think ultimately that created a very uncomfortable, weird record. And I knew it was right because then when Greg got it, he was like, yeah, there's some things I don't know what's going on here. You know, like, and he, you know, it's like when the guys in the band and everyone in the band feels that way, we know that we're treading down some new territory.
Right. And like, how do you find the pockets to put your voice on with the music?
I don't know. You know, I don't really think about it too much. I try to like take one song at a time and just beat it into my head. You know, I listen to it like 500 times, you know, like on headphones, in the car, you know, sitting around, just like looping, like while I'm doing shit in the kitchen. No, I don't really sit down and try to learn it. Mm-hmm. I just wait until it soaks in. And then after a while, things just start to like emerge. You know, I'll hear like a phrasing here and I'll hear like a melody there. And it's not something where I sit down and go, okay, here's this, I'm going to scream and this is the time signature. I have no idea of any time signature Dillinger's ever played. I couldn't list one, you know, like I don't think of music that way. I just wait till I start to like feel like, okay, here's going to be like a thing here, or here's like, you know, like you just start to physically react a little bit. And then, or maybe one day you're like, this song sounds like this to me, and you hear lyrics and patterns at the same time, and you just start like, you know, furiously writing, and all of a sudden the song wrote itself. Don't keep me down. Are there any guest appearances on the record? I saw like a photo one of you guys posted of like Brian, your old guitarist. Does he make an appearance on the record?
No,
or
he does not. But there are some guests on
it. Anything you could reveal? Any scoops?
Here's the trick about our guests on this record.
We've decided to do something that is probably the worst marketing thing you could ever do, which is we're not going to tell anyone.
So we have a bunch of guests on the record that are all like, you know, that would be like names that your record company would be like, you have to say parentheses.
We need to put this on the sticker.
Right. None of them do anything that they really do. So if we have a singer, he doesn't do vocals. Uh-huh. And we got him to hit the triangle a few times in a row or something like that.
Yeah.
Or we have, you know, one dude like just, you know, he hit the cymbals at the end of this song, but he's actually like a huge singer or something like that. Yeah. And we're not telling anybody who any of them are.
Now he gets to bash on a cymbal.
So if they ever want to tell people, they can, but we're not going to use them for marketing purposes. Yeah. That's stupid. They're just friends of ours who happen to be in bigger bands. They were like, hey, do you want to come down and do the guest Tom fill on this song? Yeah. Because it's hilarious. And like one day you can tell people that like, hey, I actually played the tambourine on that Dillinger song. You know?
It's like We Are the World, our record. There's like every, you know, there's pop singers on there. But they're like, you know, playing a trash can. You know?
It's funny, our record label doesn't even know this. They're going to be really furious that we didn't tell them that they could make a sticker that says, you know, featuring.
Tom Solo, by
exactly.
James Hetfield,
exactly.
Right?
Exactly.
And you guys are going to be on Summer Slaughter this year. I think the lineup this year is insane. I'm really excited for it. But I did notice a bit of internet backlash where people were like calling you guys out for being like pussies, which is like, have you never seen Dillinger live? You guys are, in my opinion,
thanks
one of the most
us. Now we're really
dangerous. I mean, you guys read the internet. You know, it's like, what
read the internet.
You read it. You go out. You press internet and you read it. Do you feel like you're like in a show? Or like, what are your thoughts going into Summer Slaughter?
It's so hard not to get some of it. You know, when you have like, you know, Facebook and Instagram and stuff on your own page, but really, like, on our own page, people just say nice stuff to us.
Right.
So I don't really venture off of that and try to,
I
seek out information of people saying this stuff.
People know, like trolls or whatever, know that, you know, one, criticism has so much more weight than 1,000 compliments.
Yeah, it's true.
Like, psychologically, like, there's studies that have been done. Like, it takes, like, someone, you literally have to have someone kiss your ass for 4 days to make up for one person being like, you know, that you look like kind of shit today. Like, it really has a lot of, and people love that because they feel like they can affect artists and musicians, but they can't do that to us because we are like one of the very few bands who care about the artistic, you know, side of things as much as we do, but really don't take ourselves seriously. And there's, you know what I mean? It's like,
there's nothing.
We just don't, there's nothing.
You
know what I mean?
Are you guys excited to be playing for Metallica's crowd? You guys are playing Orion?
That's nuts.
That's
gonna be crazy.
It's just one of those things where like you wish you could go back and tell your 10-year-old self. But it would actually ruin your life because then I'd be like, I can't even, why'd you do that to me, man? Like, I wouldn't even be able to make it through the next 23 years of my life if I'd have known that then, you know? I'd be like, how can I get to 33 so I can play a show with Metallica? So it's cool, but it's not as cool as you want it to be. You know, like, you're trying to, like, everything is so incremental that, like, by the time like something like this happens, you're like, oh, we're playing Metallica, that's
right. Oh, right, naturally.
Yeah, it's like, we're, it's like we're ready for inside, it. You want to be like, dude, it's like,
why haven't we played Metallica yet, damn it?
Yeah.
Well, I don't want to make you guys nervous, but last year, one of the members of the band introduced each band.
Yeah.
Someone's going to be up there being like, hey, I like these guys.
I will say that, like, you know, after, like, a time, you know, you meet a bunch of people, like, at fests and stuff, that you're just like, wow, that guy's huge. Like, you meet, like, Tony Iommi or Jimmy Page or something, like Reading and Leeds. But the only time I've ever really lost my cool was meeting James Hetfield. It was, like, the one time that I had to actually tell him. I was like, I'm trying to be cool right now, man, but, like, I'm actually kind of losing it inside. And he was really cool about it. He was really chill.
Awesome. Well, we're going to let you go. I just want to ask really quickly, is there any sort of timeline on the side projects you guys are doing with, like, Brad?
That's not even real.
It's not even, like,
no, we're just leading people on.
I see. But, like, now it's going to be, like...
I don't know. It's hard because everybody involved in every side project is busy doing other things. So, again, it's not something that we want to, like, you know, say, this is the time to do this. This is when it's going to happen. When it's right, it's right.
Right.
I think all our side projects are well into, like, the process. Like, so they are happening, and there's songs, and there's even recordings and things like that. But based on our schedules, everyone's schedules, I mean...
It's people's schedules. Yeah. It's like record release schedules. Like, you can't step on your own foot, you know, like things like that. You're like, even if one of them was done right now, like, we'd be really stupid to put it out either now or within this year even.
With everything going on. It's like
you want everything, you know, all your kids to get attention, you know, and like, even if it's a side project, you don't want it to just be like, you don't care about it. Like, we've both been working on other stuff besides Dillinger really hard too. And, you know, so it's a fine balance between, like, how do we get this done, but how do you put it out and have people see it without it, you know, obviously, like, taking any focus away from the most important thing that you have, you know.
Yeah.
So it's tricky.
Cool. Yeah. Well, thanks for taking some time to hang out with us.
Yeah,
thanks guys.
Pick up Dillinger Escape Plans, One of Us is the Killer. It's out May 29th. Is that right? 26th?
14th. May 14th.
14th?
All right, 29th.
Well, it will be out by May 29th.
It will actually be out.
We want to have a huge third week.
So, yeah, wait till May 29th.
Bumming our record label. Can we have a massive third week? So May 29th, the record comes out. If you guys can all rush out and buy it on May 29th.
May 29th.